Stationery.
Take my lips and kiss them.
Take my love.
Take my hand.
I don't need you lecturing me. I already get it enough from my father.
So this first shot starts out in Lily's car, and Adam and Lily are in an argument. Now, we do not show Lily's face, which plays in part with the rest of the film, as you see what's coming next. So, after the end of the fight, there's the awkward family dinner. Benji Solo, who is in the blue, is the kid of the mom, who is Lily Salazar. And then Adam, who's Andrew, is the son of Joel, who's in the white. So it's this very new formed step-brother relationship. And throughout the film, it's really from Benji's perspective-ish, where Benji slowly falls in love with Adam, and he is in his own little world with Adam. That's why you don't see the parents' faces or the faces of the girlfriend until the end. So as you can see, when Benji walks in, there is stuff in the hallway, and that was things that were in the room that we're filming in. So we're filming in Kristen's brother's room, and Kristen is was the assistant director slash grip for this project. She was very kind to let us use her house. So this was her brother's room, and we had to move a lot of stuff out of it to make more Adam, but we forgot. And this just shows how in a first film, you aren't super aware of the inconsistencies or stuff that will show up later. And this is one of my favorite scenes. It wasn't executed to its full potential, I believe, as most of this film isn't. But it really shows Benji's quirkiness and how he's trying to be the best brother, and how Benji's point of view, he really is trying to make the best out of the situation. Now, this was one of the first scenes we filmed that day, and it was probably around 5 a.m. in the morning, and everyone was like really tired, and this was our first shot of the day, if I can remember correctly. Just see how Adam was hiding a beer bottle down there from his new stepbrother. So this is just one of the inconsistencies that you can see, that Andrew, who is the role of Adam, is not wearing a shirt, and then he is wearing a shirt.
You, like to write and stuff, yeah?
Yeah, the school newspaper.
I could kind of use some help with something.
So this is important because Benji initiates it by tapping on the bed, and that just points out one of his quirky characteristics. And this being our first film, the directors involved, Katie Abbey, True Smith, and Kristen Olive, and speaking for myself personally, it was kind of in a fight, a new sensation directing people. And for most of it, I wasn't comfortable doing it. So a lot of this is just the actors' choices based off the character, which a lot of them I enjoy, but I remember directing Solo, who plays the role of Benji, specifically to like tap on the bed, because I feel like that's something Benji would do, as he is quirky. Now in this scene, you can see there's a blanket in the left-hand corner, and we're filming in Kristen's sister's room, where there was also stuff, so we had to move it out, and we couldn't fully move it out of the room because it was heavy, so I just put it in the corner and covered it with a blanket. And we really wanted the film to have like a 50s-ish feel, which comes and show in the outfits, or like the old phones we have in the background. We just wanted to have like a very nostalgic feeling of a cutout family.
Come on, little baby, let's rock a little bit tonight. Ooh, let's get the with the sugar, let's shake it up tonight.
So, the night before we shot, I had to go to my garage. We had a lot of, like, old beer from, like, parties because, like, my family doesn't drink, and we had to pour all of it out in the sink, so we had beer bottles. And the morning of shooting, Andrew brings a beer bottle, and it's, like, chilled, and it's, like, full on. He was like, can I use this on set to get into character? And we're like, sure. And we figured since his parents dropped him off, he had permission, so we just went with it. And I think, just like a fun fact, so the scene's like the climax that causes them to have to reunite, as you'll see now. And so this kind of shows how they're a little more comfortable with each other. Both of them are fully on the bed, but there's still like a good chunk of distance in between. And so a little bit about this monologue really fast is that this was kind of a hefty, confusing monologue that now, like, rewatching it, I would have wanted to do it better. And sweet Andrew did not have it memorized, so right underneath him out of shot is the paper so he could read it. And if you pay attention, you can kind of see him glancing down, which is, it was okay, it was just a little funny thing to add in. And about the shooting, the film stuff, you know what I mean? Our cinematographer is Connor Dalnell, and we originally had two other people who were going to do it, but then they backed out last minute. So Connor offered to graciously do it with no pay, and it was a very, very last minute thing. I think we contacted him 2 days before we shot. So it was, we never had worked together. I had just recently met him because I was an extra in his film. So a lot of the camera choices are something now I would feel more comfortable communicating with our cinematographer with, which is now our personal friend Sierra, because Connor went back to college. And it's a mixture of how last minute it was and the fact that Connor is very busy, that in our naiveness in the film process, that a lot of the shots and things aren't the way that I would have wanted them. Some of them are kind of shaky, a little bit glitching, and that's just stuff that we totally passed us by because we weren't aware of what we needed to look out for. But we sincerely appreciate Connor's help, because if he hadn't come on to this project, we would have had not been able to film it at all.
Maybe that's why I want to get good with Lil, and I'll make everything right.
So this is the montage of them working out with each other through months, figuring out how Adam can get better with Lily. So we use this old-timey calendar that our prop master, Jordan Semichula, made. And through different shots, we show them working together and getting more comfortable with each other. As you can see how close they are, working on letters to Lily. You can also see Solo did such an excellent job doing this. He has this look when he looks at Adam in Benji's character, how he's like slowly falling in love with him. Like in this scene, it was after late night of writing, and he just covers him up and they go back to bed. And you can see how he's starting to get mixed feelings towards him.
Dear Adam, I'm not really sure what to say.
So you can see that Solo had already written words on the paper, and Connor was like, it won't be noticeable in the film. And it's not super noticeable, but you can definitely tell he's just tracing the words. And this original monologue was a lot more metaphorical and poetic, but through a discussion with the writers, we decided that it would be better if it was more cut and dry. Personally, I still like the other monologue a lot more, because I feel like it makes Benji's love for Adam a lot more clearer than this one. But this is the turning point where Benji is writing Adam a letter and is wanting to express how he really feels towards his stepbrother.
No matter what, I'm going to be here to support you, whether you want me to or not. I love you no matter what.
So this is when Lily, who's Adam's girlfriend, played by Sarah Roller, is shown. Benji's bubble is broken, Adam's with his girlfriend, they're kissing, they're a happy couple. And then Adam goes up to say his final goodbyes.
Thanks. For everything, really. The letters. I mean, me and Lily, we're as good as new. You've been a good brother. That's what brothers are for, right? Yeah.
So at this part, the music gets really loud because True, who's me, had to do all the music, and it was my first time, and it was really rough. But throughout the whole film, Adam kept on enforcing to Benji that they would never be brothers, that they're never brothers, and then the final scene, he says, thank you for being a good brother, and that just ruins Benji's romantic love for him. He rips up the love letter, he leaves, the couple drives over it, and then Adam's off to college forever. Now, some of the credits are a little messed up. For example, Kristen is not a grip. She was also the assistant director, and Connor didn't do the music. I did the music, as we know, because it's kind of wacky. But it was just overall such an amazing experience to work with all of these individuals for our first film. And thank you so much for watching the director's notes of Stationery.